We have a couple of announcements. So Mary Bopp, our music director, will bring the first announcement.
We have a couple of really fun things happening for people who love to sing, whether you've sung at the Metropolitan Opera or you like to sing at home with the radio. You can participate in either or both. First, this Wednesday night, choir starts, choir rehearsals every Wednesday, 7:15. You can just walk in, or if you have any questions, you can talk to me. Also, we're having a kirtan November 10th. That's a couple of weeks from today at 3 p.m. It's call and response singing. And it's really fun, so I hope many of you can join us.
Thank you, Mary. Okay, a couple of things we would love for you to sign up for. First, our UUA Discernment Task Force is running a number of programs in November where members and friends of the congregation have the opportunity to speak with each other candidly and deeply about their thoughts about our congregation's relationship to our denomination. You can visit their table in the lobby after the service to sign up to participate in one of these offerings. There's also an insert in your bulletin that explains more about this process. And then also, as we've been mentioning, the Greater Hartford Interfaith Action Alliance, or GIA, holds its big public meeting, its Power Summit, on November 21st at Weaver High School. You can sign up to attend that event as well. I should warn you that we agreed to bring 75 people from this congregation to that event, so we need a lot of you to sign up. So far, the Quakers, I think, are in the lead with about 30, and I think St. Anthony is up there too. We're right behind them, but we got a long way to go. Finally, save this date. Next Sunday, November 3rd, 1 p.m., the Sustainable Living Committee is holding a climate cafe with UUSE member Deb Dauphiné. Deb, in addition to being the owner of Bicycles East in Glastonbury, is a certified professional rated dive educator. She's done this for over 30 years, and she's gonna talk about her experience diving in New England and sharing information about the marine life in New England. There, you can do this online as well. We'll be providing a Zoom link. That's it for my announcements. As always, there are more announcements about events in the life of the congregation on our Facebook page, our website, our regular Wednesday e-blast, and our monthly newsletter. You can always visit those places to find out more about what's going on here. But for now, I want to bring Emmy back to the pulpit. She will center us for worship.
I invite you to come into this sanctuary and take a deep and cleansing breath. Make yourself comfortable, get grounded in your seat, and be present here now. Know that this is a place of light and love. Know that you are welcome here.
All right, for our prelude, we are going to call the quarters. This is our Ancestor Day service, and in neo-pagan tradition, we need to wake up the ancestors. And we're gonna do that by calling the quarters, east, south, west, north. And we need the children, young people, come on up. We need you to help us wake up the ancestors.
Don't be shy. Come and pick an instrument. Yeah. That's a good one. That's a good one, Teddy. That's a good one. Everybody got one? All right, this is very simple. Let's get in a line. And when I tell you, I'm going to do this a couple of times. When I tell you, we're going to make some noise. We're waking up our ancestors. And we're going to start by facing the east. East is this way. I want to invite everyone, as you are able, please rise. We'll all face to the east. All right, let's wake them up. Make some noise. And ready?
It's our tradition as Unitarian Universalists to light a chalice when we come together. This morning, our chalice lighting words will be read by Josie Bernier.
Ancestors by Emily Bridget Taylor. You are carried here by so many hands, the hands of your ancestors, pouring your life like precious water from cup to cup, passing it forward, and however unsteady their hands were, here you are. So live your life like you are, thousands of years in the making.
right. Thank you, Josie. Thank you, children. Thank you, Sandra and Mary, for waking up the ancestors. And now we'll move on to our opening hymn. So please rise as you are able for number 103, For All the Saints. Please note that in your hymnals, verse 3 is going to appear on the right-hand side. Now is a time in our service, a story for all ages. This is a story written by a beloved member here, Beth Hudson Hankins, who passed away this year. She wrote this story I'm about to read to you for her grandchildren, Annabelle, Rafa, Eliza, and Elio. I had the honor of working with Beth last year on my first all-congregation service as the director here for last year's Ancestor Day service. From her hospital bed, she communicated with me and Vivian Carlson, and then did arrive here in person, and it was just a beautiful, beautiful service. So I'm honored to read her words this morning and share it with you all. It's titled, Amma's Spirit, dedicated to her grandchildren to remind you always how much you are loved. Once there was a family who loved being together. There were cousins, mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers, aunts and uncles, and grandparents. The grandmother in this family was called Amma. She loved to be outside and notice things other people did not see. She loved riding her bike, and even when it was hard, she never gave up. Amma liked to sew and especially enjoyed making things for her grandchildren. Most of all, she loved her grandchildren, Elio, Eliza, Rafa, and Annabelle. She liked to read to them, go for walks with them, and hug them. One sad day, the doctors told Amma she had a disease that would make her very sick. She went to the hospital for medicine and wore silly hats to stay cheerful. But the medicine didn't work and she got sicker. She got tired and had to rest a lot. Slowly, her body stopped working and she stopped breathing. This is called dying. Her family was sad and cried, but they knew that a little part of Amma lives on in the people she loved. That is called her spirit. The spirit is made up of love and good memories. A little part of Amma lives on in you. Whenever something is really hard, but you keep trying, that is Amma's spirit. When something is so hard, but you keep trying until it's time to ask for help, that is Amma's spirit. When you are outside and you feel so wonderful, you could run or ride your bike forever, that is Amma's spirit. Whenever you're with someone and you love them so much, you want to hug them, that is Amma's spirit. Remember always that Amma knew you are wonderful and funny, smart and strong. The love from your Amma will stay inside you forever. That is Amma's spirit.
It's a powerful story. I invite everyone to take a deep breath. If you knew Beth, hold her in your heart. If you knew anyone else who was a member of our congregation who died this year, hold them closely in your heart.
Comfort me.
Thank you, Sandy. We pause in our service, as always, for the sharing of joys and concerns and introductions. This is a very special and sacred time we share together every Sunday morning. It's a time when we have the opportunity to learn what is on each other's hearts and minds, those who choose to share briefly in a sentence or two. It's also a time when we can meet new people. It's a time when we may know and be known, hold and be held, love and be loved. I want us to take a few brief moments of quiet to gather our thoughts. If anyone has a joy or concern they wish to share with this beloved community, I invite you to come forward to the microphone. I have to move it a little bit to the right before we... All right. So, Nick, I'll ask you to light one more candle for all the joys and concerns that remain unspoken in our hearts. And I invite all of us to be mindful of how precious it is to be in spiritual community on Sunday mornings, how precious it is to have this time to learn what is on each other's hearts and minds, to hold each other in our times of sorrow and grief and struggle, and to smile and clap and even cheer for each other in our times of joy and success, our reaching of milestones, our celebrating of anniversaries. Let us be mindful that through a ritual such as this, the stories of our lives are revealed, the deeper truths of our lives are revealed, the sacredness of our lives is revealed, and indeed, the sacredness of all life is revealed. Amen and blessed be. Mary will bring a brief musical response.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mary. You know, I forgot to add, we had a wonderful trunk or treat here last night. Thank you for the committee for Children and Youth Ministry for putting that together. That's one of those events where you get a lot of people who are not members of this church who come out for the candy. It's time for our offering. I want to remind us our congregation is supported by the very generous financial giving of members and friends through the course of the congregational year. We also take a weekly offering, and we dedicate a portion of that offering to local organizations whose work helps strengthen the area's safety net or moves forward important campaigns and initiatives that align with Unitarian Universalist principles and values. For the month of October, the recipient of our community outreach offering is MARC Inc. And I want to invite a member of our congregation, Nick Glomm, to come and say a few words about MARC Inc.
Thanks, Josh. MARC Inc. is organization made up by job developers and some coaches and executive directors. There's, what I get from them is their services from the ICF building. So I'm getting a lot of good services from Glomm right now. They are currently working with me on to set up my new job skills and looking for new jobs too. I'm currently working at Big Y right now. So I've been working at Big Y since I was in I was high school student. I was in the high school training program at the time. So Big Y hired me on the spot, said, okay, we like this guy because he's a hard worker. He's loyal to the company. Well, that's when we're like a MARC. So MARC says the same thing about me. Okay, I like this guy. I want to work with him on his new skills on his job development. Okay, we can work with his bosses. So again, I'm getting good services from MARC. Again, MARC is statewide organization. My family support. I do encourage everyone to give their financial offering to MARC Inc. as well here today. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Nick. So the music you're about to hear is called Faded in the Sun. This is a piece by Lilly Coleman, who's a youth member of our congregation. I think it's about 2.5 minutes. Please enjoy. Thank you. Lilly helps out in our nursery on Sundays, so she's not upstairs. All right, so I want to offer you right now a slideshow. This is a slideshow with the images of the people in our congregation who've died over the last year since our last Ancestor Day service. I want to note one person who's included here who actually died in June of 2023. That's David Lucchetti. David was a member of our church for about 5 or 6 years. When he died, due to, I'll just politely call it, communication challenges with his family, we never observed his death here, and I wanted to include him today because I think, if nothing else, he deserves to have his picture in this slideshow. So that's why David is there. Also, the final slide is a quote. It's a little hard to read. It says, "No day shall erase you from the memory of time." This is from the ancient Roman poet Virgil, and the image is from the 9/11 Ground Zero Memorial. "No day shall erase you from the memory of time."
Thank you.
We have a very full altar of remembrance. Our practice is for anyone who would like to share a few words about someone they're remembering to come forward and do that. I have a feeling we could be here another 45 minutes. I'm not suggesting don't come forward. If you want to share, come forward. I'm just suggesting keep your comments brief. I'll model, I'm remembering my father today, and I'm remembering my grandmother, my mother's mother, who died at the age of 102. You can say a little more than that, but if anyone wants to come forward, please do.
My husband, Bill, a very, very sweet man. My mother's watch that her previous boyfriend had given her in 1941, that's another story. And my father, who was very dedicated as an engineer, one of his rulers.
I'm remembering today my mom, who died at 95, and my dad, who died quite a bit younger, and my advisor from Hampshire and his wife, Jane and Ken Hoffman, who were, Jane was the clerk of New England Yearly Meeting for many years. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm remembering both of my parents who died in late October, my mom in 2008, and my father will have passed tomorrow. It'll be 10 years. And just very quickly about my father, his name was Tom Flanagan, and he had 40 years of sobriety under his belt when he passed. He was in AA for 40 years, and when I was in junior high school, it was always confusing to me as why he was known as Tom Flanagan in the program, not Tom F., not Tom, Tom Flanagan. It's supposed to be a program of anonymity. But in my adulthood, I realized I was very proud of my dad. He saved many, many guys' lives.
I am Stacy, and I'm remembering both of my parents, my mom, my dad, my grandmothers, and I'm remembering the grandfathers and great-grandparents I never got to meet.
I'm Paula Baker. I'm remembering my mom and dad today, just two of the greatest people that you could ever wish to meet, and in particular, mom, who died exactly a year ago tomorrow.
Morning, everyone. I'm Jason Corsa, and I'm remembering my mom, who passed, would be 2 years in February, and my dad, who passed 11 years in November, a couple weeks from now, November 9th. And I'm especially, for some reason, well, it's probably the weather, visions of him have been coming to me in some breath work, but also in my dreams, more so than in any other years. So he's really trying to tell me something, or just trying to be present with me today, so, or this time around. So thanks.
I'm Maggie, and today I'm remembering my cat, my pet cat Gus, who died here this year.
My name is Vera, and I'm remembering my mom's cat. And I used to have sleepovers at my grandma and grandpa's house, and we would go around rubbing the corners of doorways together.
I brought a ring that my grandmother gave me, so I'd like to remember her. She always stayed open-minded and willing to learn, and she lived to be 24 hours away from 103. I'd also like to remember my husband's grandmother, whose memoir we listened to on our road trip this year, that just had us, had all of our jaws just hanging open.
Mm-hmm.
The memory of mine is my father's parents. We have close ties to UUSE because of them. Well, the first time we came to the church was my father's parents. God be you.
I'm going to remember something for myself, but first I'm sharing what Mary Heaney is remembering. This is Mary Heaney's grandma, Anna Flowers Jackson, who was born in 1870 and died in 1948. I'm remembering my grandpa Parker, my mother, and her seven brothers and sisters. I don't know who took this picture, but Uncle Joe was still alive and he died when I was 10, so it's more than hundreds of years ago. I don't know who took the picture, but it's really nice to have a picture of the dad and the eight children who live all over the world. So thank you to whoever did it. And of course, they are all gone now.
I'm remembering my best friend, Justin Palmer, who died in 2017 along, and he was at the age of 50, and we were, the only way I can describe our relationship is that we were soulmates, and I miss him all the time, and he's, in this picture, he's with my dog. Who died earlier, a few months before Justin did, and I have his ashes in a bead around my necklace. So these are my guys.
I'm remembering my mother and my father. But then more recently, I've lost both of my brothers, Richard and Donald. So I'm the only one left in my birth family. And I do miss my two brothers. But I'm also remembering two women from this congregation that were good friends of mine. Nancy, and many of you would remember them. Nancy Johnson and Ruth Sturdivant.
Hi, I'm Sylvia. I'm remembering Beth today. And I have a lot of memories, but this Monday I rode her bike because I broke my bike. And the karma and energy I felt during that ride was amazing. So thank you, Beth.
Hello, Sandy Johnson here. I wear a ring from Ina Maria Peterson, my Swedish grandmother, and it's from Hartford Public High School. And now I live in East Hartford, where I used to visit her as a child. It's just funny, the memories that come up driving around town.
You can switch to the pulpit. So a couple sharings on Zoom from Christina Bailey. I'm remembering my family members who died from cancer, my father, mother, sister, grandmother, great uncle. Kate Kimmerly is remembering Joe DiMilo, loving husband, father, and all around multitasker who was really responsible for getting us to UUSE. Phil Sawyer, remembering my parents, two brothers, sister-in-law, as well as Beth Kirker Stort, another longtime member of our congregation. And from David, Dave, I assume that's David Garnes, my grandmother, Sarah Garnes, and many others. And David, thank you for that. Many others. I know we're all remembering many others. We'll close with the hymn, In Sweet Fields of Autumn. It's number 52 in the hymnal. We'll have the words on the screen as well. I invite everyone to rise as you are able, rise in body or in spirit.
In sweet fields of autumn, the gold grain is falling, the white clouds drift lonely, the wild swan is calling. Alas for the daisies, the tall fern and grasses, when winds sweep and rain fall, fill the snows of December shall fill windy hollow, the bleak rain trails after, and March wind shall follow. The deer through the valleys the print of their going, and diamonds of sleet mark the ridges of snowing. The stillness of death shall stoop over the water, the plovers weep low where the pale streamlets falter, but deep in
before we extinguish our chalice and hold our closing circle, I'd like to leave you with some closing words by Lauren Brantz when I leave here. I need you to know no one has ever loved another human as much. When I leave here, I need you to know I ushered you into this life with the intent that you enjoy it, with the intent that you live it, with the intent that you see it. For all that it is and for all that it isn't, never let my absence interfere with fully living in it.
So first, to the spirits of the four directions, the east, the south, the west, the north, thank you for your presence here. We dismiss you. We extinguish our chalice flame, mindful that the flame in our hearts, the flame at the heart of this, our beloved spiritual community, and indeed the flame of all our relations, future, present, past, that flame is never truly extinguished. If you feel comfortable, I invite you to take the hand of someone nearby, and we'll say the words to our closing circle, which will appear on the screen. May faith in the spirit of life and hope for the community of earth and love of the light in each other be ours now and in all the days to come. Go in peace, friends. Have a good week.